It was the Portuguese that first established Brazil. And the language they speak in Brazil is Portuguese. Okay, now, later, I'll take you somewhere there. It's the oldest slave port around here. It was established 1510 by the Portuguese. Okay, so what is a barracoon? A barracoon is a Portuguese word that means a slave cell, prison or store. They added the word store to it because slaves were seen to be like any commodity or item you buy in the market and you keep in the store. Now, in each of these rooms, they kept 40 slaves. Now, a barracoon is the Portuguese word that means a slave cell, prison or store. Now, we have 40 rooms in this compound. But this compound is owned by the descendant of a man called William Sabat. This man himself was a slave. Okay, but right now, because of the history of this compound, the federal government of Nigeria had made this compound a national monument. So it does not just belong to the family anymore. The government took right now, it is the property of the government of Nigeria.
No.
Okay, so whenever they deem fit, they'll come around here and take the compound from the family and relocate those living here. Okay, but they now kept two museums in this compound. Now, the museums were the original slave cells.
Oh, so this is the original.
Where we go in, you see.
Yeah.
No, these three are real. But this one
is from Roots.
Yes, thank you, sir.
Yeah.
This is from Roots.
But this
picture was taken in the late 19th century.
Top is it?
Yeah. The three picture was taken in the late 19th century. Okay. Now, those three slaves were exhibited to be sold.
Where were they going to be? So, do you know where they were going to be? Because quite a lot of countries have got rid of slavery in the late 19th century. I guess America.
No. Most of the slaves we're taking from here, we're getting from the interland, not even from this town. We're getting from across.
To which country were they exported?
I'm coming to that. Yeah. Now, most of the countries we're taking from the interland, but majority of the slaves from this part, actually, now, Nigeria and Benin Republic, that's the next country, it's not far from here, the border is not far from here. Most of the majority of the slaves we're taking from there, Benin Republic and Nigeria, we're taking to the Americas.
Yeah.
That is why when you get to Latin America, Brazil, Cuba, Venezuela, Mexico, all those places, Yoruba religion or Yoruba way of life is very, very strong. Because the slaves did not let go of the culture of their ancestors. They held on to it. Now, someone came from Mexico, and I was so surprised. He came, it was two white guys and four blacks. They came, and I was so surprised. They said they came all over from Mexico, that somewhere in Mexico City, they have a Yoruba community. And I said, oh, I've never heard about that. You know, I said, he said, yeah, they have Yoruba community.
I've been there, I've seen it, yeah.
You understand? So, majority of the slaves we're taking from here, we're taking to the Americas. Okay. Now in South Carolina, there's a place in the USA called South Carolina. In South Carolina, there's a village there called Oyotunji African Village. Now Oyotunji, Oyo is the name of, there's a town in Yoruba land called Oyo. And at the present time, we have what we call Oyo Empire. That is the whole of Yoruba country, which covers towns such as in the Republic, yes. We were all under Oyo Empire. Now we have Oyotunji African Village. When you get there, now you can't live in Oyotunji if you don't have a tribal mark.
Yeah.
And it's not even in Africa, it is in the USA. Okay? I used to tell people about that town and people say, oh Anago, you started again. I said it's true. Until some of my friends met the king at Oyotunji in 2008, they had World Festival of Yoruba Arts and Culture.
Oh, this is now, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Even now. Okay? So we had World Festival of Yoruba Arts and Culture.
So
the king also came to Ile-Ife. Now Ile-Ife is the origin of all the Yoruba people. Now it's not only in Nigeria we have Yoruba. Even when you get to Sierra Leone, Freetown, another country in West Africa, we have Yorubas, but they are not called Yorubas. They are called Aku.
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 Now why did they call them Aku? Because in the beginning we don't have a uniform name. In the beginning we don't have one name for the old group, or the old community or the old tribe. Okay, now why they call them Aku is because of the Yoruba form of greeting. In the morning, Yoruba greet Ekaro, Ekaso,
Ekale.
If a man is eating, Yoruba will greet you. Eku Jeo. Now, even if you are on top of the woman making love, Yoruba will even greet you. Eku Jeo. So, everything that word Eku Eku is synonymous to the Yoruba. So, the French decided to call them Aku. And today, the Yoruba.
I know what this Kikwana.
Three towns from
you. I know what this Kikwana.
But they speak the same language.
Now, in Freetown, they speak English or Creole. But when you go to the Yoruba communities there, they speak Yoruba language, okay, but mixed. Yoruba mixed with English, just like when you get to Brazil, they speak Yoruba, but Yoruba is mixed with Portuguese. Okay, it's like that. It's not the, yeah, like it has become a dialect. And when you get to Cuba, the same thing happens in Cuba. They speak Yoruba mixed with Spanish. Okay, so the main reason, okay, what I'm trying to say is that we're trying to take it from here, we're taking it to the Americas.
We have some courses.
Okay, let's go in.
Yeah.